In darkness they came. Their destination, the Games Academy somewhere out at sea. Their mission, to become games playing legends and to crack the challenge of Games Master.
For where three teams are battling out for some of the most mega prizes on television.
And this is what the hottest team will be taking out. An Amiga 32-bit. A Philips CDI Interactive. Looks like fun. And then we've got the Atari Jaguar looking mean and moody. And finally, the PC with Real Magic Card to go to a cause of their choice.
Not only that, we've also got a special limited edition diamond encrusted Games Master Golden Joystick. Yeah! I'm ready, Dave Perry's ready. Let's find out if the teams are. The first team up from Essex are the Mega Maniacs. Yeah! Yeah,
yeah, yeah. You even dream about beating us and you better wake up and apologise.
Essex bad boys, the Mega Maniacs, take games playing so seriously they even have their own coach.
Ain't nobody gonna beat my boys.
Yeah!
Captain Russell Benson's main interests in life are chips and his weekly dose of Star Trek.
Live long and prosper.
But Russell's real love in his life is his girlfriend Louise, and his ambition is to marry her. Next up is big boy Rob Cox. He's the oldest of the players at a decrepit 20 years old. His hobbies include swimming and eating pasta. And when he grows up, he wants to be just like Clint Eastwood.
Question is, do you feel lucky? Or do you, punks?
Last up, we have Stuart. Would you lend this man a fiver, Bovis? Stuart loves the energetic things in life, such as sports and your good old raver. And if he comes back in another life, he'd like to come back as a bouncer from Neighbours.
Mega Maniacs. Good.
Brave words there from the Mega Maniacs. They've done really well to get through to this far. So, Russell, what's going to happen tonight?
Well, the other teams can, like, dream all they like, but sooner or later they got to wake up and face the Mega Maniacs.
Right, next up is the Elite Three from Birmingham. Let's go and check out a little bit about them.
We're the Elite Three. We are the best.
And we'll prove it when we beat the rest.
Football crazy Elite Three, all from Archbishop Grimshaw in Birmingham. Team captain Matthew Ward loves football and Mario Kart, so naturally he wants to be a journalist. Second is Liam Thomas. Liam's most exciting moment is appearing on Games Master. He supports Liverpool and his ambition is to make loads of dosh.
That'll do nicely.
Our final member is Ashton Love. He just loves hard men Ryu and Arnie.
I'll be back.
But in his lighter moments, he likes to settle down with a nice bowl of ice cream.
Mega Maniacs and Hummer Hawks, all they ever do is tour.
They're quiet, they're quiet.
Well, we're here on business, not pleasure.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You gonna take home them prizes?
Yep.
For sure. All right then, good luck to you guys. Right, we need got one team left, and that's the Humberside Hawks. We need to find out what's happening with them.
The basketball crazy Humberside Hawks will go to Lowestoft School and a full team. First up, team captain Sam Thompson used to collect teddy bears, but now he likes to cook. He's got 14 cats and one sister Marnie, and his hero is Michael Jordan. Next, Matthew Evans, or Flopsies is known to his mates. He hates doing the Ubering, but loves washing the dishes. Strange boy, and his ambition is to be a copper. Our last boy in blue is Paul Steele. Paul's favourite game is NBA Jam. His ambition is to be a fireman, but at the moment, he's just looking for a girlfriend. Has he met Marnie?
Seen the rest, now watch the best.
Right, you've done pretty well to get through to this far in the competition. What do you think's going to happen tonight?
Oh, I've got sorted. Easy.
Yeah?
Easy win.
Was it tough to get here, did you say?
Well, it was a pretty hard competition, but, you know.
You're through to the final? Yeah, you're going to give it a good effort?
Yeah.
All right then, lads. Right, let's get straight on the first challenge, don't you reckon?
Yeah.
Yeah, good. Right, Games Master, tell us what the first challenge in the final is going to be.
The first test of skill I've selected for our would-be champions is on the futuristic Cybermorph for the Atari Jaguar. Our contestants have two lives to collect 18 diamond-shaped pods dotted through the interstellar valley through which they must carefully guide their spacecraft, avoiding the various obstacles in their path. And the team who has the least pods remaining uncollected after 45 seconds will be the victor. As usual, I'll award 5 points to the winners, 2 to second place, and 0 for last. Let the games begin.
Cybermorph on the Atari Jaguar. You may remember in the heats, we went for all new games, and then in the semi-finals, we played it out on some classics. Now, in the first part of the final, we're going to go for games of the future. That's right, the first one is Cybermorph on the Atari Jaguar. Now, this man here is Dave Perry, our game guru. He's been my resident co-commentator with me throughout the series. Dave, do you want to just say something about the championship for the people?
Well, the standard of games playing in this championship has been excellent, but most importantly, the camaraderie between the teams has been exemplary. Yeah. People might be knocking video gaming at the moment, but don't let them knock the video gamers.
That's right. Come on, we want to see some brilliant and exciting challenges, and that's what you're going to see on the Games Master Team Championship Final. The first game up is Cybermorph. We've got Rob from the Mega Maniacs. He's going to go first. Dave, tell us about Rob.
He's probably his team's weakest player, so it could be a tactical move to put him forward, or it could be a mistake.
Right, now we're going to find out the truth. Rob, get ready. You've got 45 seconds and 2 lives to have the fewest pods remaining. Good luck to you, mate, and start your challenge.
Yeah! Okay, Rob goes herring off on Cybermorph. Down in the bottom left-hand corner, that yellow bar, that's his energy. When he hits things, he will lose parts of his energy. The lower that yellow bar gets, the less energy he's got left. And here he is to death. He's only got 2 lives in this. The pods are those diamond-shaped objects below Rob. You pick them up by driving over the top of them. The number of pods collected, or number of pods left, is in the bottom right-hand corner of the screen, above the little yellow diamond-shaped icon. He's got 12 left at the moment, and he's doing very, very well. There's 2 pods there he wants to get to. 2 pods. It's very tricky as you find your way through all these poles. There'll be a lot of baddies later. Well, his time's running out. He's just died. He's lost his ship. That's the end of his challenge. 10 pods remaining.
He actually ended up with 10 pods. Next up is Ashton of the Elite 3. Now, Dave, he's a bit of a cool customer, isn't he, Ashton?
He is, and I made the mistake of branding him an underdog in the semi-final before he won his Street Fighter 2 challenge. Yeah, he's a cool customer who says he's not here for pleasure. Let's hope he's then going to do the business on this challenge.
Right, let's see the business, Ashton. Start your challenge!
Yeah! Okay, off goes the Cybermorph. Same rules again. He's going to pick up those pods, those diamond-shaped pods. His energy bar, bottom left-hand side of the screen, that yellow bar. His ship's got before it blows up. He's only got 2 lives when that yellow bar disappears. That's one of his lives gone. Bottom right hand corner of the screen, that number above the yellow diamond, that's the number of pods remaining. Also, it tells you in the box at the bottom of the screen how many pods remaining are in green LED writing. He's lost 1 life. So can't afford to lose another. How's his time going, Jack? 10 seconds to go. And he's got 11 pods left. He's got to get 10 pods left. That's it. 1 more pod. That's going to be the end of his challenge. 9 pods remaining.
That's quite good. Okay, so the Elite 3 are in the lead at the moment, but next up from the Humberside Hawks is Matthew. Dave, tell us about it.
Well, Matthew didn't win any of his challenges in the previous heats. Yeah. Maybe tonight's the night for Matthew to prove his worth on the screen.
Right, see if you can put your teammate in front there, Matthew. Do your thing. Here we go. The top 20.
Okay, Matthew goes storming off. He's looking for those pods. There's a couple down there. Gets down nice and low, kicks up the pods. He's got to navigate his way through the big pillars.
10 seconds gone. He's not got many pods yet, Dave.
He's not got many pods yet. There's an information box at the bottom of the screen. It tells you how many pods remaining, as well as the box on the side.
Right, he's coming up.
Nobody should be in any position.
Right, let's go straight to the scoreboard and see what the current standings are. Right, so the Mega Maniacs and the Humberside Hawks drew in that heat. That means they've got 2 points each, but out in front at the moment with a massive 5 points is the Elite 3. Give them a shout! Okay, let's see the next stake. Now we need to go to the Games Master, find out what the second challenge is going to be. Games Master!
For my next challenge, I've selected the very handsome and high-tech beat-em-up Rise of the Robots for the PC. Our contestants must smash their opponents in a single round of metal-busting fighting action. Clever tactics are required in this awesome clash of the titans, as a blow delivered when the blue power gauge is at full capacity can make all the difference between victory and failure. I'll award 5 points to the winner of each bout and 0 to the losers.
So, it's a round robin on Rise of the Robots. Have we got Paul from the Hawks and Russell from the Maniacs? Dave, tell us a bit about what's going on.
We're going to have a round robin competition on one of our games of the future, which means that each team's beat-em-up specialist will play both the opposing side's beat-em-up specialist in short one-round bouts. This is a great way to rack up big points, and it means that either team could turn the championship now.
Right, the guys are in the hot seats. They're getting ready for their challenge. Start your challenge, guys. Good luck.
OK, so the Maniacs are playing Cyborg, which is the blue robot on the left-hand side of the screen.
Maniacs, that's
and the Hawks are playing Military Droid. Here's the grey robot on the right-hand side of the screen. At the moment, both fighters sizing each other up. The energy bar is at the top, obviously the green bar with energy next to it. The more that disappears, the more trouble each fighter is in. By holding down the kick and the punch buttons, the longer length of time, the blue power bar lights up underneath the fighters, letting them do special moves. At the moment, Cyborg is hammering Military Droid. He's hardly got a knock-in.
Russell and the Maniacs and Matthew the Elite Three, they're both up next. Dave, tell us what Cyborgs they're going to be.
Well, the Maniacs are going to now play as the Military Droid. In sense of fairness, we decided they shouldn't be the Cyborg both times. And the Elite Three are now going to play as the Blue Cyborg.
So, good luck to both the guys. They've got everything to play for, believe you me. OK, guys, start your challenge. Good luck.
Here we go. OK, so the Blue Cyborg on the left-hand side. That's the Elite Three. And the Maniacs are the Military Droid, which is the grey robot on the right-hand side. Once again, the energy bars at the top of the screen and the blue bars you see flashing underneath them. That's where they hold the fire button in to get a harder punch or a harder kick. And at the moment, the Cyborg is taking a pounding from the Military Droid. His energy bar's gone right down. That's the end of the challenge already. Victory for the Military Droid.
Russell of the Maniacs clinched that one. Right now, Paul of the Hawks and Matthew the Elite Three, they're up next. Dave, anything to say about these guys?
Well, Paul's going to be playing as the Blue Cyborg, and Matthew of Elite 3 is now going to be the Military Droid. We swap the robots around to make sure no one has too much of an advantage being the same robot all the time.
So, the guys are ready, they're in the hot seat, their droids are prepared. So, off you jolly well go and start your challenge.
So the Cyborg gets the first hit as Military Droid leaps in.
Now the Military Cyborg,
there's not much going on at the moment. Cyborg is just sitting there defending, waiting to strike back. Military Droid is waiting to move in. Cyborg seems to have found a tactic. That's the end of it already.
Let's go to the scoreboard, see what the current standings are. The Elite Three, unfortunately, they didn't get none on that last challenge, but they got 5 on the first one, so they got 5 overall. The Mega Maniacs, they did a bit better, got 5 on the last challenge, 2 on the challenge before, that means they got 7 overall. But in first position is the Hawks, they got 10 on that challenge, they got 2 on the last challenge, so they've got 12 overall. Yeah! Well, we have to go and say goodbye to the Elite Three, unfortunately. It's always bad news when a team gets knocked out, especially in the final. Liam, do you want to say anything?
Not really.
No, I'm not surprised. No. No, well, they're stunned into submission. Not surprised. Didn't they do well, lads? Come on, the other team. Yeah, give them a cheer, eh? All right. We don't like to send anyone away empty-handed, especially not in the final, so we're going to give them a Gage Monster Golden Joystick at least. Don't you think that's the least we can do?
Yeah! Yeah.
Give them a cheer. Come on, you know, I've actually discovered that I don't like it when people lose, but oh well, it's the final, and there's 2 more teams. One of them's going to get knocked out, and one of them's going to win. You're going to see what happens in the second half, so don't go too far away. We'll see you in a minute. Bye. Teams left in our Games Master Team Championship final. Here they are, it's the Humber Hawks and the Mega Maniacs, right? What we're going to do here is we're going to wipe the slate clean. We've got 3 challenges left. These 2 teams are going to battle it out for the winning position. So, Humber Hawks, Mega Maniacs, give them a big cheer. Yeah!
Absolutely. Sooner or later, this lot have got to face reality. The sooner they do, the sooner they can go home.
So, Humber Hawks, what to say to that?
I said at the beginning, we got this far, and we're not going to go out now.
Right, both teams are determined. We better find out what the challenge is going to be. They've got their boys behind them. Right, Games Master, tell us what the next challenge is.
First up is on the super speedy Sonic CD for the Sega Mega CD. The contestant who races to the end of the level in the quickest time shall strike the first blow. Your teams are relying on you. Don't let them down.
So, the game is Sonic CD. Now, I've got to tell you, these three games, over the next three challenges we play, they've all been chosen by the teams themselves, so they should be pretty hot at them. Right, Sam and Hawks is up first. Dave, anything to say about Sam?
Well, both these guys have proved themselves over and over again in their heats, and what better way to reward them than with the cream of platform game Sonic CD? I don't think I'm going to say anything more. Let's let the consoles do the talking.
Right, let your fingers do the walking and get going. Good luck with your challenge. Off you go.
There's an invisible level there, a warp, if you wonder how Sonic managed to jump on the net. There's a level, and he's got into the invisible secret room. It's a secret room. It's not a good thing to go into that because it takes you back as far as it pushes you forward.
Doesn't
if you know what I mean. Doesn't do any good on a speed challenge. Oh, and he's hit a baddie. That's terrible, that's lost the game. Every second counts, he goes through the flipping flop.
30 seconds
so far. 30 seconds so far, the second flipper. 30 seconds, he's almost there, he's headed for a Sonic. That's it.
Up next, Dave, do you want to say anything about him or have you done your business?
I just want to say this is going to be a very tough time to beat. This is going to be top-notch games playing if he beats this.
All right, good luck, Robert. Start your challenge.
Right, we're almost settling his turbo boost right from the off. And there he goes. He's a full pair. He gets that flipper. That'll give him even more momentum as he shoots up with. Will he go back for the slippers? Yes, he's turned about. He's going back for the red slippers. Sonic will now be a full speed. As he heads across level, the only thing that can stop him now is running into things like rocks. That's bringing up. That's it, he's on the invisible wall.
No.
Oh no, he can't get up. He's wasting so much time. That's it. I'm going to tell you, that's it. He's out of the challenge. It doesn't matter what he does. He's not going to beat the time now. It's a matter of nerves. He's playing for pride. He's going to have to go through for pride. Come on, Robert, just complete it. Just complete it for pride. Oh, and once it goes wrong, it all goes wrong on these games. Let's have a big cheer.
Challenges left, the Mega Maniacs, they've got to make it up. If they want to stay in the competition, they've got to win this next challenge. So, Games Master, tell us what it is.
Street Fighter 2 Turbo for the Super Nintendo is the next and possibly final challenge in this championship. One team must take two rounds off their opponents to win.
Well, this challenge could actually decide the whole championship. And what better way to decide the championship than with the gamers' game, Street Fighter 2? The characters are very well matched. We have Ken and Ryu, two very well-rounded characters. Stuart will be playing Ken, and Matthew will be playing Ryu.
Right, so there's not much else for us to say other than good luck, guys, and start your challenge. Best of
three rounds. OK, they both start off with fireballs. Ken catches one in the midriff as he leaps. Ryu's hit, throwing all the fireballs. Ken's trying to get in close to get a high kick. Beautiful combination. High kick, low kick, power kick. Oh, he's got a dragon punch. He didn't quite get a dragon punch in. And that's it. Ryu's got him ready. Ryu's over. First round of Ken. Very fast. Okay, a little strut in. Ryu once again firing the fireballs. And Ken choosing to use combinations. That's always the mark of a good Street Fighter 2 combination. Good fight, Street Fighter 2 competitor. It's not about the special moves. It's about the combinations. They're what do the damage. The sustained punishment that the combinations provide. Yes, a dragon punch. What a great way to decide it. Stuart wins with a dragon punch.
Two straight rounds. That means we've got one more challenge to go. That's going to decide who wins the final. Right, Games Master, tell us what the final challenge is.
The deciding challenge of this nail-biting championship is on the classic soccer sim, Striker for the Super Nintendo. Two halves of goal-scoring action will determine who shall call themselves the Games Master Team Champions. I want an honorable match. It's in your hands now.
So, the final challenge is Striker on the SNES. I've been chatting so much, my voice is gone. This is the final challenge of the series. It decides the championship. The team that wins this, well, they've won the whole final, the mega prizes and everything. Dave, do you want to say anything about the teams, the guys who are playing?
I've got nothing to say. I just want to say, good luck, guys. Thanks for making an entertaining series. Yeah. Let's just get it on.
Yeah, right, I say. So, Paul of the Hawks is going to play for England and Russell of the Mega Maniacs is playing Germany. Start your challenge.
Germany are in the green kit. England in the familiar. Shots. And it's Germany racing straight into the attack. And that's a goal.
That's a
goal. A goal for Russell and the Mega Maniacs.
Come straight on.
1-0 to Germany.
1-0 to Germany. That's the Mega Maniacs. Okay, England take the kickoff.
Both these players, don't forget, have chosen to play this game. They're both experienced players. at the bar.
Jambalaya's
run them straight away. It's coming in at the angle, I told you. That's another goal. That's another goal. 2-0.
Come on, it's not long the guy the first.
2-0. That's a favourite shot for most players, a striker. It's a bit of a trick shot. Everybody knows you can score very easily like that. That's a foul.
Free kick.
That's a foul. It's a foul.
Free kick
to England. The German wall sets itself out. That dot shows you where the ball's going to go. That's a raised line. German defender takes it. Germans are defending wonderfully at the moment. And they're attacking superbly. That's half time.
Half time. That's 2-0 to the Mega Maniacs. They're playing Germany. Pull it back now, Humberside Hawks. Good luck.
And now England races to play.
And
rattles
shot.
One in for England.
Right,
oh, got Germany again, trying to regain that two-goal lead. It's very tense. Oh, Germany is still looking the better side. They know they only need one more goal to put the game back.
Mega Maniacs have got a corner.
Germans play a long corner. Very strange corner. The ball's popped back in the area. Oh, what a great goal. That was a set piece. They obviously knew they were going to do that. Straight onto the striker, and he buried it.
Very good play, that. Very good play.
Okay, England racing forwards. Yet again. Why have they got it
England
all?
England have
just 10 seconds left.
So free. It's goals all over the place. That was Ferdinand again. This has been a good match. Come on, guys, let's see.
Germany with the ball.
It's not long left.
They think it's all over.
Germany's
there's people on the pitch.
Oh,
it is now.
It is
now. It's not a goal kick.
3-2.
Germany racing forwards.
Germany make another shot. It's the Mega Maniacs. England making
England
that
coming out. Just looking.
Dave, we've had a great time, haven't we?
It's been a great championship. It's been some great games playing. Thanks a lot.
All right, thank you, Dave. Right, let's go and have a chat with the team. You were mega and you were maniacs. Did you have a good time?
Absolutely, brilliant.
Yeah, yeah. Chuffed it?
Absolutely.
Right, oh, I've got to tell you, you were the game guru, Dave Perry's favourites for the championship.
Understandably, yeah. Really, isn't it?
Understandably so. Right, give him a big cheer!
Yeah!
Bit. They won the Philips CDI, they won the Atari Jaguar, they won the PC with the Real Magic Card, which they must give away, incidentally. Go on, what's your charitable cause is going to get this PC?
Plume School Malden.
Plume School Malden, you just got a result. Right, these are the runners-up, the Humberside Hawks. They did really well. Did you have a good time, guys?
Brilliant fun.
Yeah? And what do you think of the standard of this team here, then, eh?
Just a bit better.
Well, our other team champ as well. You give us a great time. You give us a great competition. We really do appreciate it. Please give a big round of applause to the Humberside Hawks as well. Right, guys. Some prizes. We've got a Channel 4 bigwig, Mr. Mike Miller. He's over there. Yeah. Thanks very much. Now, Games Master comes under the heading of sport, and Mike's in charge of sport for Channel 4. Tell me, what did you think of the championship, Mike?
It was megamongous.
Yes! Yeah. Okay, you've got some joysticks you want to hand out to the guys here. Now, this is our runners up trophy, Games Master Golden Joystick. Big round of applause. Special jewel encrusted Games Master Golden Joystick. Each member of the winning team gets one of them as well. Give a big cheer! Well done to all the guys. Okay, well, there's not much more for me to say than bye bye. I've had a great time. The King Championship has been really good. I think we'll be doing it again. See you again.
Yeah,
this
again,
team will be back, yeah? Great stuff, all right? Well, what can I say? But over to the Games Master for the final word. Thanks for watching. See ya.
It gives me great pleasure to thank all the teams who have taken part in this ultimate celebration of games playing skill. My hearty congratulations to this year's winners. Now, mark my words, after a well-earned rest, I'll begin the search again for the world's greatest game player. Till next time.